submitted by Hat Trick Letter, editor Jim Willie, Golden Jackass. Something big is afoot in the Shanghai gold market. It seems that we are at the door of the reset finally, with China being betrayed by the US government and US Fed in concerted collusion. The attempt to reduce the US dollar while maintaining ultra-low bond yields seems the final straw. The inference is made that the jig is up finally, and a significant turning point is upon us. A contact at Evolution Consulting has reported that his best contact notified him that VIPs are being invited to take tours of the Shanghai Gold Exchange operation. This man was among one of the guests. These tours are not being arranged in some congenial welcoming event, not at all. Rather, they are informational and official and granted preview. They are almost surely being staged to inform the opposition that it is all over for them now. With a cherry on top, the VIP guests were required to pay for the tour. The above juicy tidbit was provided by a client, passing the word along. Something big is afoot. China changed position. China seems to have changed its position toward aggressive in the gold market introduction with gusto and emphasis. Conclude easily that where there is smoke, there is fire, and the heat will be on physical gold metal demand in Asia. In turn, the pressure will be put on the US dollar, whose custodians are not honorable and for perhaps the last time, have betrayed the Chinese. Lower US dollar valuation combined with already chronic low bond yield could have turned the Chinese hostile in the wake of the US Fed rate hike. The jackass raises the conjecture, stronger and more classy than guess, that the US government and its bankster masters lied to China about a rate hike, and the Chinese are very angry. The sleazy central banker crude defaulted on the gold lease from 1999, evident in 2014. The same sleazy vile crew have used tricks like bank derivatives to create phony bond demand, tricks like reverse repo to undo the last rate hike by ramping up to dangerous levels the bond leverage, alongside massive bond default on legacy bonds from nearly a century ago. The fact that a bond is old does not invalidate the bond's integrity and requirement for honoring it. The criminal central banker crew in all likelihood stole at least $3 trillion in Saudi bonds as well, which serve as ES fund core. China has probably seen enough, and will proceed with the global currency reset. Their nation is under stress, and the imposition of the gold standard should right their course well enough, even if it derails the United States to the point of entry into the third world. London Paul believes something significant is on the verge of breaking the paper gold market. The clues have come on the behavior of the gold market since the Yellen Fed announced its small rate hike. It was small but significant, and probably involved a lie to the Chinese government finance ministers. Such coincidences do happen, but odds are against a coincidence in this case, since so critically important. Time will bear out the conclusion. The Western bankers have a long history of lies, deceit, betrayal, subterfuge, sabotage, and pilferage. They might have sacked their economies on the road to the global fascist state, but China has not signed up for the destructive evil development and pathway. Significant market hints. Euro Raj confirmed London Paul's suspicion and tentative conclusion. He mentioned that such view is absolutely right, given the market reaction. Someone at the Shanghai Gold Exchange spiked the price higher the moment the Fed raised rates, which required the paper market to follow higher. He stated unequivocally that the Chinese do not consider the US Fed, the banker cabal, and the US elite as honest business partners any longer. He expects their harsh clear revenge to follow, with the launch of the long-awaited global currency reset to come next. US President Trump visiting the Andrew Jackson gravesite was another sign, as Jackson was an archenemy of the banker cabal. He survived an assassination attempt. Neither Trump nor China wanted the rate hike. Trump does not want higher US government borrowing costs or the added economic headwind. China does not want lower bond principal value and lower US dollar value. Hence, the East appears to have burned the Western banker cabal with a paper fire that could turn into a bonfire in gold metal demand. China likely perceived a maneuver to sabotage Trump by the banker cabal, and the Beijing leaders yelled punt, game over, no more cooperation. It will soon become every nation for itself in a global free-for-all battle. It is hard to imagine the US dollar enduring what comes in an unscathed manner. The globalist bond dumping will continue until it forces the US derivative chicanery into the open with cracks wide enough to drive an armored truck through. Either the US debt market will falter or else the global trade will result in US bill rejection and payment. At least in the Eastern Hemisphere, the US dollar is about to be kicked to the curb, shunned in trade payment usage. The non-USD platforms will be given much greater emphasis. The game is about to change, to enter the extreme danger zone. Make clear the sequence. Very likely after the gold price went up in USD terms, the boys were forced to weaken the USD by strengthening the euro and British pound currencies. It was urgent to keep the gold price under control in yuan GBP terms. They gave high priority to keep the price low in order to prevent the public, sheeple, from making a bullion run on the back of political risk. Euro Raj's personal read is that the London Bullion Market Association, LBMA, is bust or close to bust. As footnote, he added that the Sprungfis gold fund has closed at a positive premium for last 2 days. New CIS dollar and gold trade standard. In time, expect an eventual refusal by Eastern producing nations to accept U.S. Treasury bills in payment for trade. The United States government cannot continue on numerous glaring fronts of gross negligence and major violations. These violations have prompted the BRICS and alliance nations to hasten their development of diverse non-USD platforms toward the goal of displacing the US dollar while at the same time to take steps toward the return of the gold standard. The new CIS dollar will arrive in order to assure continued import supply to the US economy. It will be given a 30% devaluation out of the gate, then many more devaluations of similar variety. The new dollar will fail all foreign and Eastern scrutiny. The U.S. government will be forced to react to US bill rejection at the ports. The U.S. must accommodate with the new CIS dollar in order to assure import supply, and to alleviate the many stalemates to come. The United States finds itself on the slippery slope that leads to the third world, a jackass forecast that has been presented since Lehman fell, better described as killed by JPM and Sachs. The only apparent alternative is for the United States government to lease a large amount of gold bullion, like 10,000 tons, from China in order to properly launch a gold-backed currency. The annual trade deficit would immediately render the entire batch of gold at risk of forfeit. Any such lease would open the gates for a generation of commercial colonization, but actual progress in returning capitalism to the United States. The cost would be supply shortages to the U.S. economy, a result of enormous export increases to China. Even if the U.S. government can secure such a large hoard of gold, like from Bush family and Reuben clan seizures of stolen Fort Knox gold reserves, the United States will be vulnerable from a $550 billion annual trade deficit. Its settlement after 1 year would exhaust all 10,000 tons, since at $1,300/US, such gold tonnage would be worth $420 billion. The United States is truly trapped in an economic insolvency situation, with inadequate industry and a huge unresolved trade deficit. Failure to produce a legitimate bona fide gold-backed currency, together with an adequate industrial base, would mean the United States will be confronted with a real big nasty currency crisis. Any new currency, even with gold backing, would be subjected to a series of devaluations due to the enormous trade deficit. The result would be heavy, powerful, painful price inflation from the import front. The effect would be to reverse a generation of exported inflation by the United States. The entire U.S. economy would go into a downward spiral with higher prices, supply shortages, and social disorder. However, the rising prices would come from the currency crisis, and not so much from the hypermonetary inflation. That flood of dollar trillions has been effectively firewalled off. During the crisis that comes, the gold price will find its true proper value between $5,000 and $10,000 per ounce. Then later, it goes higher, as it seeks equilibrium in a new world where gold serves as the global arbiter in trade and banking and currencies. Patrick Letter profits in the current crisis. As a Golden Jackass subscriber, I greatly enjoy listening to your interviews because it really lends a sense of passion that lies behind the tremendous body of information and formulation that goes into your monthly research. Though I must admit, it scares the hell out of me most of the time. Still, I will not miss it for the world. I feel that having a truly objective insight from your research, in-depth analysis, and accurate forecasts gives me and my family an important life-saving advantage. And I mean that sincerely. Michael's in Ontario. I have continued my loyal patronage of your excellent commentaries not so much because of my total agreement with your viewpoints, but because you have proven yourself to be correct so often over the years. When you are wrong, you have publicly admitted it. You are, I suppose by nature, an outspoken and irreverent spokesman for truth against power, which differentiates you from almost all other pundits on world affairs. Paul in Hawaii. For over 5 years I have been eagerly assimilating any and all free information, articles, interviews, etc., that Jim Willie puts out there. Just recently I finally took the plunge and became a paid subscriber. I regret not doing this much sooner, as my expectations were blown away with the vast amount of sourced information, analysis tied together, and logical forecasts contained in each report. Joseph in South Carolina. Jim Willie is a gift to our age who is the only clear voice sounding the alarm of the extreme financial crisis facing the Western nations. He has unique skills of unbiased analysis with synthesis of information from his valuable sources. Since 2007, he has made over 17 correct forecast calls, each at least a year ahead of time. If you read his work or listen to his interviews, you will see what has been happening, know what to expect, and know what to do. Charles in New Mexico. A paradigm change is occurring for sure. Your reports and analysis are historic documents, allowing future generations to have an accurate account of what and why things went wrong so badly. There is no other written account that strings things along on the timeline, as your writings do. I share them with a handful of incredibly influential people whose decisions are greatly impacted by having the information in the jackass format. The system is coming apart on such a mega scale that it is difficult to wrap one's head around where all this will end. But then, the universe strives for equilibrium.